German intelligence needs a job to be done. Let German law won't let it do.
Our unit was set up to develop resources.
We're not policemen.
We're spies.
Our sources don't come to us.
Hi, Oliver. Good to see you.
We find them.
Welcome to What the Flick, everybody. Ben Mankiewicz, Christy Lemire, Alonso, Duralde. This one of the last or the last?
The last.
I think it's the last.
This is the last. This will be the last big screen appearance of Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Yeah. A Most Wanted Man, based on the novel by John le Carré. And it is set in Hamburg, where after 9/11, the local intelligence officials don't want another Mohammed Atta on their hands, so they're all on high alert looking for terrorists. Along comes a half-Russian, half-Chechen
refugee.
Yeah, he sneaks.
Sure.
He sneaks into the country. Maybe he's a terrorist. Maybe he's not. Philip Seymour Hoffman plays the head of a very secret German agency who wants to use this guy as a way to get bigger fish, but other agencies may have other agendas. Take a look.
You can't do this. I'm a lawyer.
Lawyer? A social worker for terrorists. You've crossed the line. You're on their side now.
I'm frightened. I'm not your spy. I can't do this anymore.
You're my ears and my eyes. I need you. We have a job to do. You're going to help me do it.
Martha Sullivan, U.S. Embassy, Berlin.
Dr. Abdullah moves money through a network of Muslim charities, and every time he does, some of it goes missing.
He's moving the money to a shipping company.
He's got a lot of friends here in Berlin.
Watch your back.
The man's tolerant and engaged with the West, but every good man has a little bit of bad, doesn't he? And in Abdullah's case, that little bit just might kill you.
We have 3 hours to apprehend Abdullah, make him ours.
Hello?
If this kid lets off a bomb, it's in your hand.
Maybe you could define for us what the long-term objective would be.
To make the world a safer place. Isn't that enough?
This is a solid little spy thriller.
Yes.
And I like the fact that there is no bad guy, right? People make decisions.
Sure.
And they have consequences. And I think each person here is doing what he or she thinks is right in the moment, mm-hmm. for his or her interest or his or her organization's interests. And that creates conflict and that creates problems, but I don't think there's a villain to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting. You're right. It's more about how the bureaucracy works and what people's agendas are and what they want to get out of the situation. And what I thought was really interesting about this movie, it's directed by Anton Corbijn, who did The American
Control.
And Control. This is a movie that throws so much plot at you that it's only at the end that you realize that the theme is really what's more important, mm-hmm. that kind of sneaks up on you. And it's the idea of, do we go for the quick fix? Do we, like, you know, nab these kind of low-level flunkies and make headlines and have people think, oh, phew, that got taken care of? Or do we keep them out in the world and follow them and try and bring down these larger organizations by playing these people?
It takes a minnow to catch a barracuda. A barracuda to catch a shark.
They're moving.
So if you watch Homeland, if you watch The Americans, like, this is the kind of thing. I kept thinking of that Ben is going to love this movie because there's spy stuff in it.
I obviously haven't seen it. I'm very anxious to see it, but sounds terrific.
Yeah, I think you'll really like it. And, you know, it's very, it is, because it's Corbijn, it's all very kind of chilly and, you know, it's not super emotional, but it's no less compelling for that, and a really great cast.
It's a really great cast, and I wish there were more tension. My only complaint with it is that there are moments that you should just be gripped, mm-hmm. and because Corbin's style is so chilly and is so detached, a lot of times I wish he would just sort of, like, speed it up and, like, I don't know, more oomph perhaps of some sort.
I felt that with The American, but not so much this one.
No,
this one I kind of really was sort of into it and figuring out, who's gonna decide.
The American, I was always asking, like, why am I not liking this more? Why do I not care more? I like everything that's happening, except I don't care.
Yeah, and Philip Seymour Hoffman is great in this, you know, and he makes these really subtle choices, mm-hmm. all the time with, like, just the way he delivers a line, or the way he will, you know, undo his tie at a certain moment, or just subtle little things that bring this person totally to life, who could have just been a stereotypical old school spy.
Right. He's German.
He's German.
And there's no big sort of like Oscar clip moment,
but it's very,
you know, you really get a sense of who this guy is and his methodology and his philosophy, basically, on how intelligence works and what the end game should be. Yeah. My one quibble would be Robin Wright's wig.
Are we sure it's a wig and not just her hair dyed black?
Either way, I wasn't buying it.
She just
had the coloring for somebody with that kind of hair. It just looked like she was like a middle-aged goth girl.
I think it's meant to make her look really austere, right?
Well, I guess.
And cool and detached.
Please, if you've watched House of Cards, austere is not something she has a problem getting to, believe me.
Let me just say quickly, obviously not having seen the movie, but it bears repeating, one of the most important stories of the Iraq War, and a largely forgotten story, is that, you know, German intelligence had this guy Curveball, which was the code name for him, who was a defector from Iraq and who started this nonsense and said, no, they got weapons of mass destruction. Mm. And it was German intelligence who said, he's full of crap. You're crazy to believe him. And they screamed that from the top of their lungs, and Cheney wouldn't listen to them, and we went to war, and hundreds of thousands of people are dead. And German intelligence had it right completely. They easily broke this guy to the point where they're like, I don't think he knows anything, and all he wants is asylum, and he is saying whatever
he thinks we want to hear.
Yeah, well, frustration is a big recurring theme in this, right?
Sure. Like,
trying to get the work done. Philip Seymour Hoffman, even though he's world-weary and cynical and been around for a long time, cares deeply and cares passionately about the work, and his frustration is just palpable as he keeps fighting people on every level to get what he needs.
It makes an interesting companion piece with Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy from a couple years ago, which is another Le Carré adaptation. And it's funny because a lot of some of the interior design in this film is similar, but whereas in Tinker Tailor it was very appropriate to that 70s moment, here, since it's set in the early 21st century, it's sort of like, oh, this sort of grim German bureaucracy where they've still got the 70s interiors and the big brutalist buildings, you know, in Hamburg that they're working out of. I really dug this movie. I liked it a lot.
Yeah, it definitely requires some work. You have to be paying attention.
but it's worth it. It rewards you for it. So
it's the opposite of Lucy. Lucy is big, crazy fun.
The less you think about Lucy, the better.
I
give Most Wanted Man an 8.
I would give it a 7, but our average is 7.5. It's at 90% on the tomato meter. But it is Philip Seymour Hoffman's last role, and a great reminder of everything he did so well. Mm. He could be larger in life. He could be, you know, small and detailed. So it's a good showcase for all of his many, many talents.
Absolutely.
All right, bye.